Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us talk about how to generate the code coverage report with the Jacoco plugin and SonarQube server. Code coverage is the percentage of code which is covered by different type of automated test. Many teams use code coverage metrics to check the quality of their test. This helps you to identify how many lines, statements or blocks of your code tested using your suite of automated test. SonarQube is the leading tool for continuously inspecting the code quality and security of your code bases and guiding development teams during the code reviews. Code coverage is typically measured in percentage values. The closer to 100%, the better. Anyhow, 100% will not guarantee there are no issues with the code, but this tells 100% code is tested through automated test. Code coverage is an important quality metric that can be imported in SonarQube. The coverage report has to be computed by an external tool first, and then SonarQube will be provided with information coming from this report during the analysis. Jacoco is an open source toolkit for measuring code coverage in a code base and reporting it through visual reports. The code coverage can be enabled through various automated tests like unit, integration, and functional testing. In our earlier videos, we have seen how quickly run SonarQube server in a Docker container and bootstrap the configurations. Refer this video for more details. I have already started the SonarQube server, so I'm able to access it now. Make sure the Jacoco plugin is installed in the server. The plugin is by default installed. Use this specific API URL to check the status of different plugins. So let me search with Jacoco. Yeah, the plugin is already installed and enabled. Let us now quickly see how to enable the automated test for Java project with Maven. I have a multi-module Maven project based on Java. The module 1 and module 2 contain set of Java classes and unit, integration and functional test classes to perform the automated testing. In module 1, I have a class with name sample1.java and it has two methods, getValue and getValue1. The same way in module 2, I have two classes, one is sample2.java and sample3.java. Let me open sample2.java. It has one method, getValue. Then sample3.java contains one method, getValue. I have another module with name test aggregate. There is no Java or test classes enabled for this module, but it has only the form.xml. This module is used mainly to aggregate the test result from these two modules, the module 1 and module 2, and to generate a consolidated report. Let us now quickly see the form.xml configurations. Let me open the parent form.xml. Enabled these modules, module 1, module 2, test aggregate. This would be the last module here. So because this is going to aggregate the test result. Then some properties I defined, sonar login, then sonar password, host URL. Then you can keep this compiler source and target. I'm using Java 11. Again, Maven failsafe plugin version. I'm using the latest one. Then Jacoco version, Cucumber version, and JUnit engine version. Then again, I'm using latest integration test coverage agent. You can specify like this. Then the language of this project, Java. And coverage plugin, Jacoco. Exclusions, we are going to exclude this pom.xmls from the code coverage. Only we are going to use Java. If you want to exclude any other file types, you can add it here with the comma separated values. Then SCM provider, Git, even log level trace, you can change it if required to info, debug or whatever the error level. Then sonar.verbose, true. This will give more details in the sonar server log while we are analyzing the project. Yeah, then dynamic analysis, reuse reports. Then this is another important configuration. This says from where SonarQube server can get the reports. So here we are saying XML report path. This is the latest recommended configurations. The earlier versions use report paths and pointing to the .exec file. But the latest SonarQube server won't support that. It should be a jacoco.xml. And also through this XML report paths. Here I am using the maven.multimodule project directory. So this will give the root directory of the multimodule project, enabled in latest Maven versions, and configuring the path to jacoco.xml for module 1, then module 2, and also for the aggregated XML, that is under this test aggregate module. If you see here, the folder is little different here. Here we are saying Jacoco aggregate. The file name is same, but here the folder name is Jacoco. Then we are configuring this Jacoco Maven plugin, and also we are initializing the agent for unit test and also for the integration test. Adding the required dependencies, the latest JUnit engine, then Cucumber Java and Cucumber JUnit platform engine. We are going to use JUnit for unit and integration testing and Cucumber with JUnit for functional testing. Let's quickly review the form.xml from this module test aggregate. Let me quickly open. Yeah, here if you see again Jacoco Maven plugin. Here we are configuring this report aggregate execution, and the phase is verify and the goal is report aggregate. As we already discussed, this module is only used for aggregating the report from other modules, the module 1 and module 2. Here we are adding the required dependencies. The first one is JUnit engine. If you see here, we are adding other two modules as the dependency to this. The first one is module 1 and module 2. This is mandatory because this report aggregate works only with this dependency. So if you enable this dependency, the report aggregate will collect this report from these two modules and aggregate. Let us quickly see the pom.xml from module 2. If you see here, we are configuring set of plugins. The first one is Maven Surefire plugin. This is used to run the unit testing. If you see here, we are excluding some files, it.java. It means the file ends with it is integration test cases. The next one is failsafe plugin. So this is for integration test. There we are setting some goals also, integration test, then verify. Here we are including the files only ends with it.java, means integration test cases. Again, we are configuring this Jacoco Maven plugin, and the goal is report. Then the required dependencies, JUnit engine, Cucumber Java, Cucumber JUnit platform. Let us quickly review the pom.xml for module 1. This is going to be same as module 2. Same here, unit test plugin we are configuring, then integration plugin, then we are configuring the Jacoco Maven plugin for report goal, then the required dependencies. Here we are adding only this JUnit engine. Why? Because we are not going to do functional testing on this module. The functional testing is enabled only on the module 2. So that is the reason the Cucumber related dependencies are added only to the module 2. Let us now review the unit, integration and functional test cases enabled in module 1 and module 2. Let us start with module 1. Let me go into src test java. I have two packages, one for integration testing and another one for unit testing. Let me open that unit testing sample 1 test.java. If I go here, I'm testing only this method from sample 1, new sample 1 dot get value. So only get value method is tested here. If I go to sample 1, I have two methods, get value and get value 1. So again, asserting this equal, it should be sending back 10 as the response. Now if I go to the integration testing, this is just for a demo, but real integration testing is going to be different. So here again, I'm testing the get value 1. This is a different method. It should be returning 20. I'm testing for 20. So through this unit and integration testing, the complete this sample 1 class is covered. As we discussed earlier, various automated tests can be used to cover the overall code. Let us quickly see the test classes from module 2. Let me go to src test java. Here again, functional test and unit test. Here we are not having an integration test. We are doing unit testing and functional testing. Let me open this unit testing again. If I go to sample 2.test, so sample 2 dot get value, checking for the response 10. If I go to sample 2 get value, yeah, this is the only method in the sample 2 dot java. So now let me go back. If I go to functional testing here, again, I have a two classes here, sample 3 test step dot java, then sample 3 cucumber test dot java. Let me open this class first. Yeah, this class just notify there is a cucumber functional testing enabled just with this annotation at cucumber. So that's fine. Before going to this class, let me show you the cucumber feature file. For that, I should be going here, SRC test resources. So if I go here, then I have the package com coverage demo. Then I have module 2, then FT. So then I have sample 3 dot feature. So this is the package com coverage demo module 2 FT. So if I open this, this is the BDD based development, functional development. I am setting two scenarios here. The feature, the cucumber Jacoco coverage sample, then two scenarios. The first one expecting to receive 60, given when then, whenever a value is 50, get value method of sample3.java is called, then it should return 60. Then another scenario, same, receive 100, whenever a value is 90, get value method of sample3.java is called, it should return 100. Now, if I go back to this steps, this is the definition or implementation of that feature file. So if you see here again sample 3, I'm functional testing this sample 3. Then given input, whenever a value is that specific number, setting this to input. Then I'm invoking this sample 3.get value with that input. Then validating the return value, output and response. If both are matching, the test is success. Now the test classes are ready. Different test, unit, integration, and functional test are enabled to cover the overall code. Let us quickly analyze the code. I'm going to run this Maven command from this root folder, mvn clean verify sonar colon sonar. The build is success. Even the analysis report is uploaded to SonarQube. This is the URL to access the report. So before going into SonarQube, let us see the local report. Let me first go into module 1, target, then there is a folder called site, then Jacoco, then index.html. You can open this. This will give you the coverage report for module 1. Let me open index.html. Yeah, here you see module 1, the coverage is 100%. Then click on module 1, then sample 1. Yeah, sample 1 is covered, then get value and get value 1 is covered. Let me go back to module 2. Module 2, same target, site, Jacoco, index.html. Again, module 2, 100%, sample 3 and sample 2, both 100%. Here, sample 3 and get value. If I go back, sample 2, get value and the constructor. Let's view the aggregated report. For that, go back here, test aggregate, again, target, site. The folder name is different here, Jacoco aggregate, then again click on index.html. Here you can see both the modules, module 1 and module 2. Module 1 is 100%, module 2 is 100%. You can again go inside module 1, individual files you can view. Same way you can go to module 2, individual files you can view. Let us quickly review the report from SonarQube server. Here we see coverage again 100%. Let me click on the project. And if you see again here 100%, if you click on this, it will show you all the details. Sample 3 files we had, all are 100%. Also here you can see little more details, coverage 100%, lines to cover, then uncovered lines 0, line coverage is 100%. Yeah, if you see here, the quality gate is failed. Let me click. Yeah, the quality gate is failed. If I go to this quality gates definition, if you see AEM, so then let me quickly look for the coverage. I am saying 75%, but our coverage is 100%. If the coverage is going to be less than 75%, the quality gate will fail. Anyhow, this time it failed for different reasons. Then you can generate the code coverage report through Eclipse. For that, you should be installing the ECLMR plugin to Eclipse. Let me quickly do that. Go to help, Eclipse marketplace. Search for ECLMR. Yeah, install this plugin if not installed already. Now you should be able to generate the code coverage report for individual modules. Now let me go here. Let me do that for module 1. Right click. Then code coverage as JUnit test. Yeah, you can see this is 100%. The minimum details will be displayed here. Even you can go into this individual files and see the details. Yeah, you can even go and check this file. So this will be more useful during the development. You can modify the code and immediately you can see the improvement on the code coverage. The code coverage is one of the important measurements to identify the effectiveness of the automated testing. Different type of automated testing can be used to enable the overall code coverage. The sample code is posted to this Git repository, YouTube data, then test coverage report, Jacoco. I will be sharing the details in the video description. Feel free to provide your comments. That's all for today. Thanks all for watching the video. See you in the next video.